Sure.
We're gonna play Ink. Give me a second. Let me update the stream, and then Jay is gonna play Ink.
Okay.
We'll see how this goes.
Oh, what? What?
Terrible things are happening. Hold on. Ink plus fingers. Ink. Nope, that's not how you spell ink.
It's only three letters.
Why, Jay? Not helping. And update. And
is this a controller game?
It is a control. Well, hopefully it's a controller game.
Okay.
There you go. Switch with me.
Okay.
Switch with me. Jay's gonna play the Yink.
All right.
This is a game that I've been looking forward to a lot. This is a simple platformer, and the premise is you kind of have to splatter ink around the level in order to find the level. Oh, I hope it's controller supported. Oh, yeah, okay.
Oh, this is the game.
This is the game.
I thought this was like a loading screen or something. What?
Huh? Press A to jump.
Oh, I see.
It's cute.
Oh. What?
Double jump.
There we go.
Jump off the wall. You can get higher. Yeah. There you go. Attaboy.
Attaboy. You're doing it, Jay.
Double jump from that high area there. Where you're at now, maybe. Yeah. Oh, there's a thing up there.
Oh. There we go.
That's kind of neat.
Exactly. Some Twigs Inc. says it's like Super Meat Boy, but made of paint. Yes, that's exactly what this looks like.
Yeah, so you gotta get up there.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. Okay. Ah.
Ooh.
Oh my god.
Boop,
boop,
boop, boop.
Ah!
Oh no! Oh, thank you, Captain Nipik. Yes, this is Ink.
Damn it.
Ink of a nice little indie game.
Solid. Now without India. I don't know what that means.
Damn it!
You're right, Lawson. Technical.
I'm not good with the controllers.
This does have Shawshank Redemption music.
I guess now I gotta watch Shawshank Redemption.
You really do.
Yeah.
I mean, I know I should have seen it by now anyway. I just.
This is the only game besides DuckTales that Jay has played in 25 years.
It's true.
Well, and that was an Outcast, Outlast.
Oh yeah, that's right. You played Outlast for a little bit.
Which one was Outlast?
The horror one. The Asylum.
Oh yeah, I liked that one.
And Quap. You've had...
Quap doesn't count.
You've had a slew of very strange names.
Do we want to just go straight to the Asylum game?
How do you get up there?
You jump off the wall.
I'm trying to do that. It's too narrow.
Yeah, like, you can jump out, but then...
You can double jump.
Jump back. You can do it.
Like, no, you can't jump back in.
Yeah,
you just fly out.
Jump out and then press back in.
That's what I'm doing. Yeah. And it just makes you fall over.
Oh.
It just pushes you back out. It won't let you go back in.
At this point, the level is now completely painted.
Yes.
We're
just
trying to get where we need to go.
Yeah. There you go.
See? You overshoot it, though.
It's gotta find it.
You gotta learn to compensate.
Find the bounds.
Ah!
Get those Heisenberg compensators up and running.
What?
It's a Star Trek thing.
Oh.
I think I'm already sick of this.
You're a crazy person.
Well, this is stupid.
Oh, you're a crazy person. Jay, just because you don't get the art.
Do we have Mario?
I can play the shit out of Mario.
Can Jay play Pokemon?
There we go. God damn it.
Can Jay play Pokemon?
I'm scared that there's gonna be no ground.
I think that's part of the give of the game is like just figuring out where to go, you know. Oop.
What?
Oh, too far.
Yeah.
That's cute.
Gobbledygook says, Jack, I'm guessing this game is trendy. Possibly trendy. It just came out. I remember reading about it a long time ago, just because I enjoy platformers.
Ah.
It's probably trendy. It's a new game. Does that make it trendy?
The controls are frustrating.
I can't see this holding my attention for long.
Yeah.
And that's fine. It's not your type of game.
I think my problem is, like, I get what you're supposed to do. I think the controls are sort of frustrating.
Well, it's a more modern platformer, and I think you're not necessarily
used to old platformers with tight, responsive controls.
Yeah, I think that's probably it.
There's a different kind of responsiveness, I think.
This is like, I always hated in, like, old Mario games and stuff. Actually, maybe it wasn't Mario, but I hated old games where there was, like, the ice world where you would slide, you know? That's what this reminds me of. Like, I always thought that was the most frustrating thing.
So close. I don't... Jay probably wouldn't like playing Bloodborne. I think Jay would just like to watch Bloodborne, though.
Yeah. Well, we don't have the PlayStation 4 here, is my guess.
Also, yeah.
We're stuck to what's on Jack's computer, so no Rocket League.
No, basically, if Jay doesn't want to play this anymore, but I'm playing it, is what's happening.
Yeah, I don't have the patience to learn new controls.
Hey, anytime
I can feel Jay's unhappiness.
That's fine.
It's more. It's not unhappiness so much as frustration.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where it's like, I know what I'm supposed to be doing, but...
He's very sad.
That's fine.
I'm crying on the outside. All right, take over.
Aww.
The Z step to my
chat with Rich about stuff. Chat with Rich about stuff and nonsense.
Right. Why haven't you seen The Shawshank Redemption?
I don't know. I don't have any good reason. It's one of those things where it's always been like, I know I need to watch this, and I'll get around to it eventually. But I gotta watch those Friday the 13th sequels for the 27th time. You know?
You're being honest, though. I appreciate that.
I do need to watch it. It's one of those, it's always like, in the back, like, oh, someone will remind me I need to watch it, and I say, oh, I do. And then I kind of forget about it until the next time someone brings it up.
You know what, Jay? These controls are a bit shit.
Oh,
okay, see?
This is
all right.
This is not necessarily Jay.
All right. Now I feel better.
No, I mean, not necessarily.
I'm sure that it doesn't help that I...
No, it has a very strange momentum about it.
Yeah.
All right. But that was my first level, too. So give me a second.
All right.
Boom.
Thud.
Give me a second, thud.
Something new.
Did those kill you?
I should probably jump on it. Yeah. I can only assume it killed me. Yeah, like when you move, like when you jump, you go from 0 to 100.
Yeah.
Like you
it
move.
It feels like you don't have much control over.
Isn't that just like Super Meat Boy though?
No, Super Meat Boy has a wonderful momentum. Like Super Meat Boy feels very natural. This like, it feels like you're moving way faster than you should. Like there's almost like no gravity. You know, like gravity should slow you going left and right as well because it pulls you down,
mm-hmm.
And it feels like it doesn't slow you down at all.
What the fuck?
If that makes any sense.
Sure, of course.
Just say this.
Yeah, right. Just say.
These things seem like they defeat the purpose of painting the level.
Yeah. And they're not very dangerous.
Right.
Well, we're still getting introduced to them.
Kill them all.
Something is off about these controls. Jay, I'm so sorry for... I'm sorry
well,
for...
Well, I'm glad that it's not just me being bad at the game. I mean, I know I wasn't good, but...
I feel bad now for doubting your gaming abilities, but no, this...
You had every reason to doubt me.
This thing does not move like you think it would.
Yeah.
Is the real thing. Is not, and it's very frustrating.
Ah, nope.
It's fine.
Ah, okay.
All right.
What are you?
A cube. You're a salt cube.
You're sometimes programmers don't know how to draw characters.
It's just a square, whatever.
You know, I know how to make things jump. I don't necessarily know how to draw things.
So you're just an abstract thing.
Yeah. Art! I love the concept. Like, just doing that to splash on a level is so neat.
It's old at this point, but we should probably play a game called Gish.
Gish?
It's where you're like a little... It's like a physics platform where you're like a little jello blob.
Gish? Can we say Gish?
It's an old enough indie game that I'm not sure if you can find it on Steam.
You guys chat about stuff.
One of those I heard about when PopCap first started up.
Oh my god. Back before PopCap was an evil...
Yeah.
...entity.
PopCap?
Yeah. They make games. Smaller games.
But they're evil?
According to Jack.
Why are they evil, Jack?
Isn't PopCap like the...
I'm just familiar with old PopCap, so...
PopCap makes, now they make like microtransaction-y, like.
Do they? No, that's bad.
That's what cookie clicker type games, don't they?
I don't know.
Oh, I get, you know what? I don't want to besmirch.
I remember Bookworm, I remember Peggle. Remember the original Plants vs. Zombies?
Oh, I know that one.
Yeah, that's PopCap.
Okay.
Heart.
Does anyone remember Zombies Ate My Neighbors?
That's a quality game.
Was that for Nintendo or Super Nintendo?
Super.
Okay.
And Genesis, Jay.
Well, I had it for Super Nintendo.
Well, aren't you special?
I never had a Genesis. I always had the Nintendo systems.
Doesn't it feel like you should be able to reach that?
Yeah.
Guessing there's some sort of secret way to get through it. There you go.
There you go. You earn nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Yay!
But now you can say, yeah, I got that thing.
I got that thing. That's all I wanted. Nope. Nope.
Are you getting used to the controls?
I feel like I don't like this game.
Because of the controls?
The controls are a big part of it. Like, they are...
The idea is cool. Like, it's a neat concept, and it looks good, but...
And, I mean, this is a game that I should love. Minimal and arty.
Eh.
Well, not me.
I know. I'm weighing in myself.
And you're saying meh.
Meh.
Yeah. And that's, it's a lot of meh. Just mostly because the controls are shit.
Can we play Zuma?
Zuma?
Never mind.
The frog game?
This Zumba? Is the thing with the, you shoot the marbles.
Yeah. Zuma! You shoot the marbles from the frog mouth.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's my favorite flavor of Pop-Tart? That's a great question, Gobbledygooks. The only answer to that question is s'mores.
I would
is
need
a
some
Pop-Tart flavor?
Yeah, it's the best fucking Pop-Tart flavor.
I would need some kind of rocket eyes to read that chat.
Or normal eyes.
Oh my god. Everything's so small.
I'm sorry?
What would you know? You wear glasses. You've got, like, built-in magnifiers on
Why
your
don't
face.
You have it on the other monitor like you usually do? Because you've got a system with different things set up here?
Well, I could. I was unsure. The TV is also coming out of the computer. And so, like, we could plug it into that. But I was sure, I was unsure if that, like, would draw too much power or... I guess I figured that Rich could read it because, you know, I assume. I mean, my glasses don't give me super sight. They make me see normal.
Tree Rock Creations. I have not played the new King's Quest game, and I gotta be honest, I don't have much interest in it because it looks nothing like the old style of Sierra games. It looks like a modern Telltale game, which is probably a lot of QuickTime events and very little actual puzzle solving, so. Meh.
Fucking hell.
You can put a name of something I like on a new product, but it doesn't mean it's gonna be like that thing I like. So.
I won't be able to. Jack can't see Jack getting visibly frustrated.
Oh god, this thing moves like. Basically, all I'm trying to do now is get my money's worth out of the game because I am not.
How much did you spend on it?
I want to say it's like $4 or $5. You know, like it was not terribly bad.
You could have gotten a taco.
I could have gotten at least two tacos, depending on my taco establishment.
Well, if you want to go to Taco Bell, sure.
Yeah.
They have tacos for like 50 cents at Taco Bell. Is it just like cheap garbage?
Garbage at Taco Bell?
Don't they have like a whole menu of stuff that's like 70 cents? Like under a dollar?
Jay, they're the only restaurant that survived the fast food wars.
Oh, that's right. Yes. All restaurants are Taco Bell.
The greatest in-movie advertisement ever. AKA... All fast foods are Taco Bell. All restaurants are Taco Bell.
You know what? I'm going to say Demolition Man.
Yeah.
Highly underrated movie.
Agreed.
The execution might be so-so, but the premise? Top-notch.
What I always say is that people that love Demolition Man love the first half or so.
That's
like satirical. And then the second half is just generic action movie.
The satire part, though, so good.
The satire stuff, yeah.
So good.
Yeah, the first half is great. I get bored by the second half, because then it just turns into boring action movie.
Tell the suspect to calm down.
All that stuff's great, yeah.
please put down your weapon.
Wesley Snipes shows up and they just don't know how to handle him.
Say it again in an authoritative tone.
Add the words.
Please put your weapon down.
Add the words or else.
Yeah.
Fucking Demolition Man. I love all of that movie. Even the bad action.
Does Wesley Snipes get decapitated at the end?
He kind of.
Does he get like frozen?
He gets frozen and then he kind of kicks his head off slash slash shatters him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay.
It's so much effort to compensate for the shitty controls. Or maybe that's the game. You know, maybe it's like Octodad. It's not shitty control. What it is, I don't think it's shitty controls. I think it's... I'm gonna be mean here.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna be mean. I think it's lazy programming. I think that the...
Well, at what dollar value is lazy program acceptable?
Exactly.
Because I would say the McMillan and Id game we just played, Fingered, lazy programming.
Not lazy program, that's lazy art.
Well, that's okay, but that's part of lazy something.
Lazy something.
Lazy something that's an important part of the game.
Yes. Yeah. Agreed. I agree. Hey.
Do you give them a pass and not this game?
No. I thought that game was equally as frustrating because we couldn't play the game because of the bad part of the game, right? For any money amount, it's unacceptable. Obviously, their game was half as expensive as this one, so... Sometimes you just have to stop. Just stop it moving and, like, just reset. Fucking hell. If you charge for something, there is an expected value. And, so, no, they don't get a pass either.
Let me just see.
Yeah, go ahead.
Let me get a feel for this.
Get it. Rich is now giving this a try. Take a level or so, get acclimated. Do you, dog? So bored of this game. I'm sorry. Listen, we had a grand plan for tonight, and this was part of it. Finally got it. Oh, it's not even 10 yet. It's fine. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. Whoa.
Oh.
Whoa. So the last thing to check off my things to talk about list. I'll start talking about it now while Rich is playing and he can overhear. It has to do with the game Batman Arkham Asylum. And Rich and I, so slight spoiler alert for the ending of Batman Arkham Asylum. Obviously.
Oh, you mentioned this once. Yeah, I think I know what you're going to talk about.
Obviously, it's been a while since the game has been out, so I think like we're kind of past spoilery territories. But for the next 10 minutes or so, if you want to mute... We're talking about Batman Arkham Asylum.
The ending, specifically.
Specifically the 100% ending. Not just the normal ending. So, spoiler alert, now. In the end of the game, the world finds out that Bruce Wayne is Batman. And he blows himself... Or someone blows him up. Someone blows up Wayne Manor. It's alluded to that Bruce Wayne...
Fairly strongly.
...blew up himself as Operation Nightfall. As part of... Because he tells Alfred, you know, begin Operation Nightfall. And then he goes to his house and it blows up. But then, cut to maybe like a year later, right? And the voiceover narrator says Batman's gone and people are moving on and some thugs are robbing another rich couple in an alley. And suddenly they look up on a rooftop and they see a Batman figure. And they go, hey, you don't scare us no more. We know the bat's dead. And then the Batman figure on the roof turns into a smoke monster and attacks them. And there's like fire and explosions and, you know, it's like
The Batman blows up, turns into a giant bat, and the building he's standing on also kind of... I wouldn't even say blows up, but... Some kind of explosion, fiery, spread out
mystical thing happens.
Did Damon Lindelof write this?
Right. It's a bullshit ending. And Rich and I had some theories on the ending about what we wanted to happen and what actually did happen, but someone tweeted at me a reasonable idea of what that ending means, because in the entire game the Scarecrow releases fear toxin over all of Gotham. Okay. But the only people left in Gotham are criminals. And so what their theory is that Batman is really not around. This is residual fear toxin. The fear of the Batman is still around. And that's what... So there was nothing up there. There was no bat symbol. There was no nothing. Okay. It's just the Scarecrow's fear toxin working. And I thought that was really interesting.
It's bullshit, though.
It's 100% bullshit.
That means the Scarecrow is responsible for solving Gotham's crime problem. That that explanation is 175% unsatisfying.
Yes. It means that Batman did
and the
nothing.
Likelihood of that being the intended thing that's going on is like 0%. That's what's going on.
I think that's already enough where I believe it.
I can see Batman using the fear gas for his own reasons, but I cannot see that being.
You could see Batman using Scarecrow's chemical warfare.
Yes, I can. The Batman mentions he's going to need to do something extreme.
Yeah,
and that is obviously the extreme thing he decides to do.
Yeah. My spoiler warning was for the wrong game? Didn't I say Arkham Knight?
You might have said City or something weird.
I might have said a different Arkham. Well, fuck it. We're past spoilers for the game. The game's been out for how long now? Months? What's normal spoiler territory?
I'm going to say you're wrong about the controls. It's fine.
Really?
Yeah. I think you're just not used to playing platformers.
Okay.
Jack, I'm going to say you're too used to Meat Boy. This is fine.
It's not just Meat Boy.
This is fine. This is easier to me than Meat Boy.
What?
Yeah.
You're a crazy person.
No.
Whoa. What's happening?
You're a crazy person.
No, this is fine.
This control.
This is 100% fine.
I think
you're going full force with the controller and you're not being subtle enough.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, this is fine. Look at this. I'm having no problems.
Well, I see that.
Whoa! It's extreme! You ever see that video on YouTube, every 90s commercial ever made?
Oh god, that's amazing.
There are spikes in this game.
Ah, there's invisible spikes! Of course there are.
Go out and watch every 90s commercial ever made, right now.
Oh yeah, that's a great video. That's that, famous YouTuber. Speaking of famous YouTubers.
Is it Smosh? Did Smosh make that
video?
It's
not Smosh. It's Brandon Wong? Brandon W? Not Brandon Wong.
Oh, Freddy Wong?
Freddy Wong. Thanks. That's a
I know that name, but I have no idea who he is.
Brandon is the
I
other
know
guy.
He's a YouTube person.
Freddy Wong. Brandon was the other guy on that channel. Freddy Wong. He did that.
Yeah, I feel like all of these mistakes are me. I don't feel like the controls are fucking right. At all.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It didn't feel natural to me. Like all the his movement did not feel
this
right.
This is worth the $5.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So saith Rich.
Alright.
This is worth the fiveth coin. Oh, you missed the heart.
Yeah, fine.
There's a heart.
I don't give a fuck. What do I get? Achievement?
Rich is nailing it.
Yeah.
So, I guess Jay and I are wrong. And, you know, Jay
well,
can't...
Well, you're wrong. I have an excuse that I don't know anymore.
Right, Jay can't be blamed, so it's me, I guess. This did not feel good to me. Is all I can say.
But, yeah, I make mistakes, but I feel like those are just me.
I mean, obviously, you feel how you feel, so that's fine. I'm trying to explain it.
I think, more so than you being weird, I think you're just used to Meat Boy. I think you're used to Meat Boy, and it might not control exactly like Meat Boy does, with the velocity and whatnot.
Yeah. Well, I don't think it has a velocity. I think it has an on or an off, is the problem. Whereas, you know...
I'm not having a problem.
Well, I see that.
Yeah.
I love the premise. I love the paintiness.
Yep.
I'll be forever down with the paintiness. But yeah.
Pew, boom.
What does this art tell us about the human condition? That's a good question. That's a good question.
It tells us we like colors. we just love colors.
You know, it's a metaphor. And basically what the game is telling us is sometimes in order to find the right path, you gotta get a little messy. You can't be afraid to put in the work. And even failure...
You can't be afraid to spill paint everywhere.
You can't be afraid to spill paint
So
everywhere.
Go into your garage or your parents' garage.
Yep.
Find as much paint as you can and start tossing that shit all over the place.
Especially not your garage. Go to not your garage and just toss...
Go to a neighbor's garage. Yep. If their garage door is up, just take all their paint and start spilling it everywhere. Yeah.
But see, like, even when you fail in this game, you splurt paint everywhere, right? And that shows you the path. And so it's saying, like, even failure sometimes is important in life. This is a rich metaphor for the struggle of the artist and some other bullshit, I'm sure. And some horse malarkey. What is horse malarkey? I don't know.
You grew up on a farm. You should know.
touche.
You should be the expert on horse malarkey.
On horse malarkey? You're right. You're absolutely right. Also, it says that you should crush those that get in your way. And that the only way to succeed is by crushing those around you.
Mm-hmm. The lamentation of the women.
I was gonna say, yeah, the coded thing. What is it?
See your enemies driven before you.
Yeah, how does the whole thing go?
We just did this the other day. Someone in the chat reminded us.
What is best in life?
What is best
to
in life?
Crush your enemies, have them driven before you,
and have the lamentations.
And hear the lamentations of the women.
The women. Yes, these are the best things in life.
See, this is why I haven't seen Shawshank Redemption, because now I'm thinking about the fact that I need to rewatch Conan the Barbarian.
Absolutely.
And that takes precedence.
If you see Shawshank Redemption, you'll be thinking about how much you need to watch Shawshank Redemption again.
I mean, I can't...
That's one of those movies, every time I see it's on, when I used to have cable on TV,
yeah.
Every time the Shawshank was on, I just stop instantly and watch the rest of the movie, no matter how many times I've seen it.
Okay, but here's the thing. On cable, Shawshank is on, and Conan is on.
Shawshank.
I don't know. Some days are just Conan days.
This is fine. Nope. Well, no more under that. All right.
Fuckers who haven't seen Casablanca have no leg to stand on.
Casablanca's fine. I saw Casablanca in the theater. Yeah. Not when it originally came out, of course, but
there we go.
I did see it in the theater.
It's a fine movie.
It's a good movie.
It's fine.
It's not when I feel any strong desire to revisit anytime soon, but...
Hmm. Any of those classics. You know, you watch once, you're like, okay, all right. That's why people like this one.
There's some, like I know we talked about Citizen Kane before. I genuinely love Citizen Kane.
Right.
I can rewatch that. Casablanca,
ooh!
You know. I respect its place in film history. It's fine, but...
That was neat.
Yeah, moving now.
Whoop. No! The lamentation of the boxes.
Crushing the enemies. The moral of the game is even when the people around you don't seem to be hurting you in any way, you must crush them in order to achieve your goals.
Oh no!
That's good advice.
Oh no.
Bye-bye. Oh, what a terrible way to die.
But by the way, that was the best splat of them all. That orange one.
Yeah.
That was great.
No! I don't want to crush to death. That's horrible.
You can do that. You can reach your goals. Be everything you can
be.
Oh,
no. Oh, no.
Every time I pump iron, it's like I'm having sex.
It's like I'm coming everywhere.
It's like
everywhere.
I'm coming everywhere. You can do it. Be with me.
Also, everyone here who hasn't seen Pumping Iron should go see Pumping Iron.
I think it's on Netflix.
Is it?
Or it was. I don't know if it still is.
That's the most bizarre fucking movie in the world.
That came up in the chat last night because...
Pumping Iron?
We were watching Star Trek fan episodes.
Okay.
And Lou Ferrigno was in one.
Oh, yeah?
And somebody in the chat was mentioning, you know, in Pumping Iron that Arnold kind of screwed over Lou Ferrigno. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen Pumping Iron, so I don't know how he screwed him over, but... It's just kind of weird that that comes up again today when you weren't involved in that conversation last night.
Well, you know, you talk Arnold. I think Pumping Iron has to be a part of it. You know, everyone knows Arnold the movie star, but, you know, Arnold, and everyone knows that he was a bodybuilder, but, like, watching that documentary, man, he's a weird dude. Him being a movie star is one of the most bizarre
and it can only events. Happen at that point in history.
Yeah.
It can only happen in like the early 80s.
Yep.
You cannot have a guy like that become a big movie star today, I don't think.
No.
Can't speak English very well, but play American cops. My head is giant, my arms are giant.
Someone with no acting ability whatsoever, but gets by on just pure charisma.
Pure charisma. And an accent. And the fucking weirdest name in the world.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. His career is beautiful.
He made some great movies. That they are currently shooting a sequel to Kindergarten Cop starring Dolph Lundgren. I'm assuming it's going to be like a direct-to-video thing.
What?
It's actually a real thing that exists that's being shot right now.
I don't necessarily believe you.
No, it's true.
I'm going to go and flat out say I like this.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, Kindergarten Cop or
this? This.
Kindergarten Cop 2. He likes that idea.
I don't have a tumor.
You did? Right.
Tumor.
Okay, no, I think that's fine. The controls weren't it for me. I love the world. I love the art so much. I don't know, maybe if I played around with the controls more, I could get it, but... On
it's,
first
it's
play...
It's less floaty than Super Meat Boy.
Meat Boy felt
better. It felt like I was coming. To go back to Arnold. I mean... You know.
Oh, spikes.
Oh, spikes. Maybe you're right. Maybe I came in expecting Meat Boy. And it's not that. But...
I know I keep bringing it up. I just, you know, I want to give this game a fair shake because I'm enjoying this. I don't have a problem with the trolls. I don't want to make it sound like, your opinion is invalid.
Of course.
I want the other side to be heard.
Oh, no. And I guess I'm doing my best to elaborate
my
feelings.
Yeah.
And I think that's fine. It's perfectly okay that we have different opinions, I guess.
Right.
Of course, no matter what, as always, we'll get lumped into the same opinion. So what do you think we're going to get lumped into? Do we love this game or do we hate it?
We're going to get lumped into the hate.
You think?
Yeah.
Even though you're saying you...
We never get lumped into like.
Yeah, that's true.
People gravitate towards hate.
Yeah.
Even if you're talking about something that you really like, if you mention one thing about it that you didn't like...
Yeah. Daredevil?
Oh, you hated it.
Yeah.
That's the way it works.
Star Wars quote. Should we Star Wars quote here? To hate something. Let it. Where do you go now?
I know. I gotta get on the other side of this. I gotta get on top of it as it's going the other way.
Oh.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
No, actually, that's one of my favorite parts is, like, every death shows you the path, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Visually, I'm in love with this game.
Raya juice. You got this Raya juice.
I can't stop doing Arnold.
Don't stop.
Just don't. Just be Arnold.
Be Arnold for the rest of the night. We have a guest tonight. Arnold Schwarzenegger is here.
Yeah, that would get him. He just has a great voice. Everything he says is the most ridiculous thing in the world.
Of course it is. I mean, the reason he's famous is because he's a cartoon character.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just the truth.
Yeah, that's true. Give the game to Rich? Well, I can. I bought the game.
Yeah.
I can't. Now that I've bought it, I can't give it to Rich, but it's fucking $5. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that Rich can afford $5 out of the money that comes out of pre-rec anyway. So
I'm not worried about this. Yeah.
So it'll be fine. Also, he might have the login to my Steam, so he might just be able to play it no matter what.
Oh,
I thought you had it there.
Alright, fuck the heart.
Fuck the heart, yeah. What, Captain Nipik? We have a real guest, the developer of Ink is in the chat? Or the developer of Mute Crimson Plus, what we played earlier? What is happening?
What is happening?
What is happening? So it takes me a while to catch up with the chat sometimes.
I don't believe we'd have two developers in here for two games in one night.
You never know.
Stranger things have happened. Arnold Schwarzenegger became a movie star.
Wait. You think that's stranger than him becoming the governor of California?
Okay, that's strange.
You know, that makes sense. Ink Dev showed up too?
What?
I'm suspicious.
He's been here for the better part of 10 minutes?
I'm suspicious.
He's always been here.
Who are you? Says he's one of the devs of Ink. Ale-liddy. Oh. You should be ashamed of what you've done. No, we're talking about the game. I'm not ashamed. Thanks for showing up. Ooh. So why cubes? That's the question. Why cubes? President Trump.
President Trump is not going to happen.
President Trump is not going to happen.
Even if he somehow wins the vote,
yeah.
The Electoral College is just going to say, no, fuck that.
Yep. No. Like, if it looks like he's even close to winning anything, everyone's going to be like, okay, joke's over now.
Yeah.
We're going to stop covering him because, like, it was all funny. It was all funny while he was saying, you know, dumb racist stuff. Like, we all got to laugh out of that. But
I suppose someone over at Fox News is, like, saying, oh, my God, look at the monster we've created.
Right?
Our cartoony worldview has spawned this. Our mockery of real politics turned life itself into a caricature.
Ooh, what's the... They said the game was a submission to Ludum Dare 32. What's Ludum Dare? Is that like one of those game jams?
Like a space jam?
It's like a space jam.
Well!
But instead of getting into the slam jam, up in the slam jam... It's actually more like a 48-hour film festival where you have a certain amount of time to make a game.
Oh, well, that would make sense.
Yeah, so I can only assume that's like that. A lot of games have come out of game jams, space jams.
Ooh, things to dodge now. Oh my God, this is getting intense.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Oh, I got cocky.
Jesus H. Christ. Rich, I think it's getting real now. Oh, that's right. They got the Space Jams, your Game Jams, and your Jimmy Jams. All sorts of jams.
Oh, shit.
Thanks, Hosmike.
So is there any way to confirm that we have the actual developer of this game in the chat?
You know.
I twice in one night? Weird. Too weird.
Eh.
Do an interview. Ask questions. What do you got?
Huh?
Let's ask some questions.
Let's ask some questions. Okay. Oh, apparently. So yeah, Ludum Dare is a 48-hour game development competition. So much like 48 Film Festival, so where you have to make a game in that amount of time, and then they, according to the quote-unquote dev, they spent 3 months for a full release, and we got this. I think that's great. I think that's fun. What the other that other game I was playing, that Titan Souls, that also came out of a. Out of a game jam where they had like, and you know, much like the 48-hour film festival, that you have rules that you have to adhere to, make your game around a theme. I think that's neat. No more political talk. All right. I can't imagine we were saying anything.
Political talk to make fun of
Donald Trump? No. Though. No, of course. Well,
real politics don't come into play much.
But Jay, that's
just
political
the big
talk.
Goofy buffoon.
Making fun of Trump and making fun of Fox News, that's not making fun of somebody with actual conservative views. Because I think everybody knows that both of those things are just caricatures.
Caricature.
Oh, thank you, Grammar Nazi.
Caricature. That's a hard word to say.
Not really.
Caricature?
Caricature.
Caricature. It's one of those words where if you say it more, it sounds like not a real word. Caricature.
That's most words I've discovered.
You think?
If you say it over and over, it stops sounding like a word.
Caricature. No, oh see, yeah, Ice Lizard Game is still here. I know. I've been emailing you, so I know we know that's really you. We assume.
I assume we're being played.
Huh?
The safe assumption is that you're being played.
Always assume that people are full of shit.
Like when we had the Strafe guy on, we never confirmed that it was him. Right? We talked to him for like 3 hours.
Because we could start talking to this guy.
I
didn't even know his name in the chat yet, so I apologize to the person who was supposedly a dev of this, but
yeah.
like 20 minutes from now you're gonna say, "Suck hard, search butthole," and then you're gonna leave. It's always a possibility.
Right. It is.
Baba booey.
and when we were talking, you know, we were Skyping in with the guy who made the Strafe game, and like I said, we talked to him for like 3 hours. And never
That'd
once.
That'd be great if it turned out that it wasn't him.
Right? Never once did it occur to us. Never once did it occur to us that it could not have been him. Hold on. And I think that's funny. I'm a trusting person. I'm going to go ahead and say it. I'm a trusting person. Alejandro Hiti just tweeted at us. And looking at his Twitter, that's really him.
Okay.
That verified.
I just want to verify. I'm just being, you know, rather than look like an idiot.
I'd rather look like an idiot.
Oh, sure, he's Louis Sosa. Okay.
When in doubt, don't trust
anyone. Yeah.
I can only imagine that you would be discovered rather quickly. I'm not saying that you're wrong. In fact, you're very right.
There are people out there who have posed as doctors for years. This has happened.
Yeah. No, I agree. I'm with you.
That's what I was doing before Red Letter Media.
You were being a pretend doctor?
I was a pretend doctor, yeah.
Really?
A podiatrist, actually.
There was one, I think, who even did, like, surgeries. I think he was counting on, like, the people around him to do most of the actual work.
Oh, my
God. That's terrifying.
Yeah.
That is scary to me. It's like my worst fear. I have enough of a fear about like disease and stuff.
Uh-huh.
To find out that the guy operating on me isn't a doctor. That would be my worst nightmare.
Nope.
If you go off the edge, it counts as a jump.
Oh, so I'm waiting too long.
You're not jumping fast enough.
I'm being too worried about the jump.
Yeah.
All right.
You can make that double jump. You just have to jump a little sooner.
So once again, the fault is mine. Okay.
Absolutely. I mean, the fault is always yours, Rich, is I guess what I'm saying. Oh. Everything about this game looks fantastic. I love the fact that triangles are pissed off at squares. Right?
They're jealous of that extra side.
You fucker! And right, the other enemies you crushed were rectangles. The poor man's square. Everyone knows that.
You know the boss.
Get it together,
the boss rectangle. Is gonna have to be circle.
If there's not an angry circle at one point.
I did it again.
You did it again. It wouldn't be hard to pretend to be a dev, especially for an indie game. You're right. Oh yeah. What I'm saying is, Rich and Jay are absolutely correct, and we should be concerned about being. Oh, actually, speaking of, this is something I wanted to make sure I mentioned. Is speaking of being legitimate, Rich and I have gotten many legitimacy questions because I set up a previously recorded Gmail email address. Just because I needed to get stuff done quickly, like start up Twitter and whatnot, and I didn't have an at Red Letter Media email, but we finally took care of that, and so now...
We did, though. Huh? We set it up when we first started doing pre-rec stuff.
Did we?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
I think you just don't remember.
I just don't remember.
It did exist.
It did exist, but either I didn't know about it or I forgot, which is more likely. Let's be honest, nope. That's more likely. So anyway, we now have... in use an official prereq at redlettermedia.com. So I will be transitioning all of our email correspondences to that email.
Look at that. MLG Pro. MLG wow. Pro.
I think we're going to call up Red Bull and they're going to sponsor you. I wonder...
They'll call me the Red Bull. Rich the Red Bull Evans!
I don't think they would want to take away from their brand like
Wow.
I did it. I just can't imagine there's much in the world of competitive ink play right now.
At least not outside of like an S&M club.
What?
What?
I don't know. I'm reaching.
These are the jokes, everybody. They ain't much, but this is what we got.
What?
I don't know!
I'm just trying to... I just took a moment. I was just really trying to...
trying to wrap your brain around what that could mean?
Any sort of ink and
ink
S&M...
Ink play just sounds like something that's supposed to be geeky.
Sure. I guess.
I don't know what it would actually involve, but it sounds like something that wants to be kinky.
Sure. Yeah, you know, we got all the kinks here. We got
ink play, ink play.
We got S&M, ink play, horse play.
We got squitching.
You know, you
splashing. That's a real thing.
Splashing?
Splashing is when you or your partner pour food into each other's like privates. That's a real thing. There's a magazine devoted to it. It's the most disgusting.
That's the most disgusting
thing.
Like, as
far as fetishes go, that just makes me want to barf.
But that's also a fetish.
Yeah, golden shower. Everything's a fetish. But splashing is particularly gross to me.
Oh, that is the grossest.
Just a bowl full of spaghetti right in your crotch.
Right, you want to know what the square's name is?
What?
Roy G. Biff.
Roy G. Biff. Okay, Biv. I get it. I
Biv.
Get it.
Biv.
Yeah, Biv. Yeah. The spectrum of the
when rainbow. And when you die, it's a Roy G. Biff.
No.
Up top.
Tried.
Up top.
No.
Rich
Jack. Let me know in the Jack high five himself.
Rich just gave me.
And that I had nothing to do with that
Rich
high five.
Just gave me the sweetest high five ever for that awesome joke. Roy G. Biff. He was like, man, good joke. You didn't hear because he turned away from his microphone. But he said, good joke. And then he gave me a high five, and everything's great.
I hate so much about the things you choose to be.
Yeah, food and sex should not go together. Those are separate things.
I feel sorry for the dev. He comes here to listen to somebody talk about his games, and we're talking about S&M clubs and Ragey Bim.
Sloshing.
This is, if this is anyone's first previously recorded live stream, this is what happens. We talk about the game for a little bit and then discuss whatever we feel like for the rest of the time. And, you're welcome.
If we had a talk show, it'd be called, I don't care what you're doing.
What you do? Well, we would get the promotion out of the way. Okay, what movie are you promoting?
Yeah, yeah.
What are you doing? All right, great. What do you want to bullshit about?
So do you have those new Cheetos? Those beer Cheetos? Beer what Cheetos. A disgusting idea. I just made something up. Okay. It wasn't as bad as Doritos.
What?
What?
Mountain Dew flavored Doritos.
Is that a thing?
No, wait. It was Dorito flavored Mountain Dew.
What?
Somehow that's grosser.
Yeah, that's worse.
This was a test flavor. There's pictures of it on the internet.
Oh, Doritos God. Flavor Mountain
Doritos.
Doritos? I've never heard of this. Wait, was this recent?
Yeah, I think so. Look it up.
You're looking up.
It sounds like the most disgusting thing ever.
You're looking up splooshing, aren't you?
No, splashing. Oh God, there it is.
Splashing? Stop
no,
it.
No, Doritos.
Ew, Doritos.
It's like neon orange.
Ew.
This is the right thing anyway. Doritos. Yeah, it's bright orange.
And you didn't trust me.
You're right, Doritos sounds worse than splashing. Would you rather with Doritos?
I'd rather drink a Doritos than splosh.
Yeah, I mean you're right, but that's not a word.
How about you splosh with Doritos?
Oh God! Don't even barf. How about you barf? I forgot your name already. Alejandro, if you are still in chat, who did the music for this?
He left.
Yeah.
Once
yeah.
we started talking about Doritos.
Was the final straw.
Who did the music? If you're still here, if you're listening to us in the background while doing more important work, tell me who did the music for this. Because I bought this, I did buy this with the soundtrack. Because I enjoy the soundtrack a lot. No, he's still here. I see you in chat. I fucking dig the music. This is some shit I can listen to.
These triangles are just nightmarish.
The triangles?
Yeah.
Well, they're out to get you.
I know they are. They're difficult to solve, so.
Yeah, I like it. I like how they're kind of spazzing about while they wait to shoot you. Vincent Rubinetti. Thank you. I will copy and paste that name into Twitter as I dig this.
Ah!
Sometimes, like, when I'm working with After Effects, I enjoy, like, the techno-y, like, just kind of keep me striving.
Sure.
But, you know, sometimes you just...
A bit more ambient once in a while.
All the time. You need a little something like this. Perfect After Effects-ing music.
What?
Really, any sort of instrumental music. You can't deal with lyrics when you're doing After Effects.
Yeah, that's why I like the synthwave stuff. Most of it's just music, not lyrics. Shit.
Oh, Jay, they're asking for a Nuki update. How are we on our Nuki levels?
Well, just need a couple more.
Yeah. You people need to see the Nuki shelf.
The Nuki shelf is pretty impressive at this point. We got, if you haven't seen our Twitter, we have a Nuki pillow somebody sent us.
Uh-huh.
So we also have that.
It has to be something they had made special.
They ordered it off of Etsy, so somebody made it. It's like a craft.
Very nice.
But it's in the it's like the perfect, it's larger than a VHS tape, but it's the right shape. So it looks like an oversized VHS tape, but it's a pillow.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, that's great.
That is beautiful.
I'm doing it! I'm doing it!
It's working!
It's functioning.
Oh!
Oh, you jinxed it.
Hello, Draco. I use Premiere more because most of my work is actual editing. Obviously, for any compositing, I use After Effects. Lately, I've been using After Effects more because we're doing effects and only effects, and I'm not editing
space.
Space what?
Space. God.
What's that?
It's a movie that's never going to get finished.
It's that thing that'll be done eventually. It's getting there.
It's getting there. If all goes to plan, there might be a Space Cop effect stream on Sunday.
Ooh.
One of the problems with that is right now I don't have an office because there's some remodeling happening at my house. And so it might not happen if my office isn't ready. But I'm thinking it might. Also, I need to do some of the effects first to make sure that I figure them out before I stream how I'm going to do them. So, but yes, coming up either Sunday or maybe next Wednesday, we will stream light bar, space cop car, light bar effects after effectsing. It's going to be
super exciting.
It's going to probably be the most boring stream we've ever had. But it'll be a lot of fun. Maybe. It'll be a lot of fun or very boring. I'm sure, like most of our streams, some people will like it and some people will not. That's a
okay.
That's a bold statement.
Yeah.
I know that's a bold statement. Oh no, I'm not getting a new office, I'm painting. I just had to move everything out of my office to paint it. And I didn't want to get paint on my work computer and equipment.
Snob.
I know. I didn't want to ruin the things that I use to make a living. And so, it'll be done shortly. I'm hoping by Sunday.
You should edit in a closet. A broom closet. like a man, Jack.
Right. Right. No, I'm just, I have literally nothing to do with the editing of Space Cop. I'm doing some special effects work.
Nope.
Who's primarily editing? You or Mike?
Yeah.
Okay. Jay is editing Space Cop.
Well, I edited Space Cop. Editing is basically, not completely, but majority of it is done. Now it's just lots
effects
of
and sound.
Effects, cleaning up the image, which I got a lot of that done already. That's been time consuming, like months of work.
Space Cop.
There we go.
Oh my god. Oh, so you can bump into the hollow triangles.
Yeah.
But not okay. I'm with you. Rich is the RLM Foley artist. He has a special routine.
We put my ass next to the microphone.
We put different parts of Rich Evans next to the microphone. It's sometimes ass, sure. Sometimes other body parts. Depending on what noise we need. You should expect a very special behind-the-scenes video for Rich's Foley work. I want to say it's more instructional than...
We should make a behind-the-scenes Foley video. It's just like 30 minutes of farting.
It'll be me making like the most pathetic sound effects for whatever.
Yeah.
And there'll be an extended.
Just with your mouth instead of any sort of like.
Oh yeah. And it'll be there'll be a whole section with you and Mike like listening to it and just like nodding. We gotta just let that pause. I promised Rich to get this out.
He's been listening very seriously and like I think that like the second take. That was good.
I like how you started that one.
The good on Shadow.
Splash.
Pew. 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 Pew.
Wait, Rich, can you end your laser sound with a little more oomph?
You!
Perfect. Cut print.
Yeah.
Copy the print. And duplicate the copy of the print.
This is easy enough. It's getting back up.
Now you get it.
That's gonna be a nightmare. Shit. Okay. Nope.
Now you're getting it. You can do it. I gotta take a breather.
Nope!
What was that? What was that horse shit?
Nope.
Are you trying to get up and around?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's like you waited for that one. You guys want the Bew to be the new subscriber sound?
Bew! Bew! Bew!
Max Payne, that was the first bullet time game,
yeah.
Right? That was its big claim. Oh my, oh, that was.
See, that's funny. Getting up is gonna be a nightmare. No! Oh!
I think the answer is they don't know. Probably not. What do you mean online screening, Pizza Train? Jay,
what?
Space Cop question. Spent 4 years making a movie and they want to see it.
Huh?
They want to see it.
Yeah, but I don't understand online screening.
They want it to be streamed.
It's very doubtful it will be streamed anytime soon.
Oh, well, but it's like even when it's done, it's like what point would streaming serve if you could have it. Pizza Train, I guess I don't understand your question. Do you mean like an early screening for Patreon supporters? You know. I don't know.
It's very unlikely. Yeah. We'll see. We don't know what we're doing really yet. We just want to get it done.
That's the most important. Stream with some sort of live commentary.
It'll probably be a commentary track.
Yeah.
It's gonna have to be multiple commentary tracks. Years worth of stories.
Right.
I think that's fine.
Yeah.
Gotta move faster, Rich. You can do it. It's gonna be like a 4-disc set. Space Cop is 1/4 of 1 disc.
I don't know that I'm gonna be able to get back up there.
can do it.
No, I can't.
I think you have to, like, jump around it.
Ow! Fuck that up again. Keep fucking it up. Oh god, I did it! Oh my god, I'm on a moving thing? This can't be done!
This can't be done! This can't be done! Suck it up, Rich. Oh, or just do it like that. Oh,
oh my god.
Oh my Jesus. Nope. That's my favorite. Is when it looks like you almost aimed for it.
How many levels are there?
Alejandro?
Oh yeah, the developer's still in there. How many levels are in this game? And how far along is Rich? This looks like it's gotta be... Like, I mean, this is getting pretty intense.
This is getting ridiculous.
It's gotta be close to the... One of the final stages, I would think.
No!
It's like, Rich is 1% through the game.
Oh, no.
Yep.
That's fine.
Not even close.
Oh, there's so much content. Oh, no.
I just mean, I'm just picturing, like, as hard as this looks.
Right.
Like, how much harder it's going to get.
Oh, my God.
Fuck. The one thing I don't like is that falling off the edge, you should be, like, almost off the edge before that counts as the double.
Oh, sure.
I'm, like, kind of near the edge, and it counts as, you know... Ah.
This is, close to level... This is, like, level 47 or 48, and there are 75 total levels.
Okay.
So you're over the halfway mark. I don't think you can. I think you have to wait for the thing to come.
Actually, I came very close to doing it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You gotta wait for the thing.
I got to that wall once, Jack. I know what I'm doing.
Yeah?
I know what I'm doing.
All right. All right. Rich says he knows what he's doing, guys. He's going to try to make this jump. We have someone in the chat who might know whether or not that jump is possible to be made.
Well, I need to go up that wall first.
Oh, and actually, Alejandro says something he was working on today was to give players an extra frame or two before the double jump.
Oh, nice, nice.
To avoid the ledge issue that you're having.
Nice. Because I am doing that a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is a normal video game thing, like, you know, falling off of a ledge counts as a jump, but yeah, the detection.
But I'm not. It's like I'm not quite falling.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
See? I beat the system.
That was nice, Rich.
God.
I beat the system.
I did. What do you call that, Jack? What do you call that kind of elite jumping skill? I don't know.
Pro.
Do you?
Pro. Super pro gamer. Sponsored by Red Bull. Rich is the Red Bull. Rich is the Green Bull. You can't be Red Bull because that's the name of the drink. They're not going to name a player the Red Bull, right? They're gonna call you the Ultra Bull.
They named a soccer team in New York the Red Bulls.
Really?
Yes.
After Red Bull?
Yes.
And that's soccer. Nobody likes soccer.
Soccer is the most popular sport in the world.
Nobody likes it.
But nobody likes it.
Not a single person likes soccer. I don't believe it.
Yep.
To be fair, the ones that do like it don't call it soccer.
That's true. So you're right. Nobody likes soccer.
No, yeah, that's... See? I know what I'm talking about.
Everybody likes football.
Football.
Football,
like Red Bull.
Like Red Bull. We're on.
There's a connection somewhere.
We're on to something here, guys.
I know what it means.
I got this. I'll handle this. I'm the football expert. So many footballs. Yeah, the New York Red Bulls. They are owned by Red Bull, and they are an MLS team, a Major League Soccer team.
Mm-hmm.
That's insane.
No! Oh!
Is Jay and Rich excited for football season?
No.
Yeah. As much as I always am, I like watching the games. I root for the Packers.
Yeah. As somebody who roots for the Chicago Bears, I haven't been excited about football for the last 30 years.
Oh, it's sad because it's true. Oh my God. Oh my. Oh.
MLG Pro.
That was a beautiful run, Rich.
Thank you. Oh my God.
Oh, it's the Mega Triangle.
I think I know what I have to do.
What do you have to do? Oh my God.
No!
Oh, the spikes are falling.
Yeah.
Oh, you know. I didn't see the spikes. Have you seen What We Do in the Shadows?
No, that's one I've been meaning to.
What is that one?
It's like a mockumentary comedy.
Okay.
About vampires. And it's, I think it's a lot of the Flight of the Conchords people.
Oh!
And okay. Jermaine Clements in it.
Sure.
It's supposed to be very funny, but I haven't seen it.
No. Well, there you go. Well, there you go.
Am I doing something wrong? I'm not sure if this is working. But I'm not sure what else I can do.
Do you have to jump on him when he's still?
Okay.
Yeah, there you go. You can jump directly on him.
I just assumed I couldn't because spike.
Right. And then him hitting the spikes kind of stuns him. Oh, you have to stop for it. Okay. We're figuring it out. Game.
Though, for developer's sake, just the fact that he's a spike made me think that jumping on him would be a bad idea.
Absolutely. That makes sense. It's a poke.
Yeah. Especially when spiky things have killed me before.
Spiky things are killing you in this very level.
Yeah.
But you figured it out. You used your brain. Oh, I haven't seen that. Have you seen the new guy, the man from Uncle?
No.
The Guy Ritchie.
I don't like that Guy Ritchie.
Yeah?
Yeah. I don't like him.
What's he done recently?
What's he done?
What's he done?
He did Snatch. He did Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels. He did Swept Away with Madonna.
What?
One of the worst things ever.
He did Madonna. For a while.
One of the worst things ever.
One of the worst things ever.
Snap.
Yeah, I know everybody loved Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels. To me, it was just like the style was aggressive and obnoxious. And
it was different, really, is what
I'd,
it was.
I'd have to rewatch it because I haven't seen it in well over 10 years. I just know, I think I saw it when it first came out on video.
Sure.
And it got on my nerves.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I remember, like, the style was so refreshing. Like,
I thought it was aggressive. Like, aggressive and annoying, but.
Oh, it, like,
that's
oh,
all
I,
it had.
I agree. It was, like, it was aggressive, but it was. And maybe it was just because it was British.
Yeah.
But, like, it felt different.
I'd have to revisit it. I remember really not liking it, but I haven't seen it. Very
look who the
time.
Enemy is this time.
I knew it.
Circles.
I knew it.
So maybe the circles aren't the final boss. Maybe
they're heat-seeking.
Maybe it's a...
Well, it's going to be the daddy circle.
Well, for this level, but maybe the end boss is something fucking crazy like an octagon.
Pentagram.
Yeah. A
pentagram? In a circle.
Pentagram. That's crazy.
Why? It's geometric shape.
Yeah, but that's a more complicated geometric shape.
Yeah, head boss, Jack. Head boss. Use your brain. Use your lion brain.
It's all crocodile here. You know that. You know that.
Oh, this is difficult. I hate these things.
Good. I think you should. Boss. The boss is Satan. Like in a in a stark turn of events, the boss is like. Is like a Satan from Doom.
Yeah.
Like a real character, you know?
That would be great.
Wouldn't that be weird?
Fuck you!
Answer this before. Jay, have you since watched Danger 5?
I haven't, yeah. It's on my list.
Yep.
Along with 5,000 other things.
Of course. The first season you'll love.
Well, the second season is the 80s one, right?
Yeah.
That's the one I think I would probably like.
It's not... The second season is not done as well.
Okay.
The first season is pitch perfect 60s, 70s Italian B-movie satire. Everything about it is perfect satire.
I can't get past that second one. I always get hit.
Yeah. There you go.
Ooh.
There you go.
Yeah, you did it. Yeah!
But in the second season, even though they try 80s satire, they stick with some of that 60s and 70s filmmaking satire, but have like 80s tropes.
Okay.
And it does not play nice together. Mm-hmm. But the first season is wonderful.
The circles, I think, are too much for me right now. they're too much for me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Have you hit fatigue?
Probably that has something to do with it.
Sure. Well, that, you know, that's okay. We've been going for like 4 hours.
We'll see if I can get to the end of this. If I even start getting close to the end of this, I don't know. We'll see. Oh, dear.
Try to get to the end of this level.
Yes, yeah.
You can do it. Oh, listen, Ultimazer, I agree. Like, there's some fun in season two, but it's not. Season two is more insanity than satire, and season one is a perfect satire. And so I felt even
and
though
that's, it's the same guys that did that Italian Spider-Man, right?
Yes. That was a question mark. Yes.
I thought that's what I heard.
So Italian Spider-Man was done as a parody.
Yes.
Okay. I didn't know this.
Huh? A good parody. But season two has wackiness and craziness, and it's off the rails.
Oh, God.
But it doesn't have that, you know...
It's
like,
not as sharp, well, as focused.
Like, for example, in season one, all exteriors are obvious miniatures.
Okay.
Which is glorious.
Yeah.
They keep with that theme in season two, even though they're supposed to be skewing 80s movies, but they would never use a miniature as an exterior shot in an 80s something. And so they try to keep the style of the first season while incorporating 80s tropes. They try to keep the style of a 60s or 70s Italian B movie while incorporating 80s tropes like high school slasher films, and it doesn't mesh well. And the Hitler joke gets old very fast for anyone who's seen season two.
Fuck!
Hitler in general is overused in like crazy comedy. Like that Kung Fury movie, the bad guy's Hitler. It just seems like the go-to like, comedy bad guy now.
Yep.
It's like, I don't know, he's overused.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, fuck!
Right? Rich agrees about Hitler.
Fuck my nutsack.
You know, I just don't know how that's possible, Rich. I'm just going to put that out there. You can do it.
I cannot. My goose is cooked.
Your goose is cooked?
Yeah.
Fleet fingers, Rich.
10 more tries.
10 more tries.
1. 2.
Oh, agreed, Mar.
3.
Season 1 of Danger 5 is far superior to Kung Fury. Season 1 of Danger 5 is a must-watch. especially for people who like bad movies. Like, it's wonderful.
Do the jokes on Danger 5 work? Because if so, then it's better than Kung Fury.
Five.
Kung Fury is so much funnier when it's not trying to make, like, actual jokes.
Six.
Yes. Yes.
The style is funny.
Seven.
The serious tone of it is funny, but then there's parts where it's like, it turns into an infomercial for a second, like an advertisement for, what was it, a phone or a fax machine or something? I don't even remember.
Nine.
It's like horribly unfunny.
Ten. This is it.
You got it, Rich. You got it. You know it's up. You know it's up.
Yeah, that's it.
Give it a try.
Yeah, okay, go for it. You got. Remember, you got to crush those things.
Oh my god, I did forget that.
Yep.
You can't go through the door.
God.
Right? Oh, there's no way I'm gonna be able to do this.
Part of it's fatigue, but I may have hit a wall.
Oh, sure. Well, you know, it's the fatigue wall where you've been playing platformers for the past 4 hours.
Circles are the ultimate nightmare.
We took a tiny break to play Fingered, but you've been playing hard as balls platformers for 4 hours. I got this. I know what to do. It's simple. This is simple, Rich.
Pizza Train. The prereq email is prereq@redlettermedia.com.
That's right. We're legit now.
Oh.
We're so legit.
This is the first time I've paid attention to the chat all night. And I was glad I could be informative.
You nailed it.
With my answer.
You nailed it. My idea is not working. I thought I had it. I can get here. Okay, hold on. I can do this. You get here.
Nope. You're just doing the same thing over and over.
I know. Well, that's what it looks like.
That's what it is.
I think you got to go backtrack for that one shot.
Oh,
that.
Sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't forget, you gotta kill the things.
One, I forget. Two, I'm not very good.
One, two, dodge. One, two. One, two, dodge. I'm trying to find like a rhythm now. Oh my god!
Yep, I got this. This is what I was trying to do in the first place. Is like get to the. Oh no! Just kill me.
Oh, now you're. Now you're.
No, because you know you can't. Oh my god!
This looks impossible. Oh god!
Dodge. Oh god! I need to go watch Demolition Man. That's all I know.
Just watch the first half and you'll be fine.
Oh, watch all of it. And you know, it's action garbage, but it's good garbage.
Is that the last good Stallone action movie, like, of that era?
Was that the beginning of the end, is what you're saying?
Yes.
I think that might have been in the middle of the end. I don't remember when Judge Dredd was, but it was probably right around that same time.
I think it was after Judge Dredd.
It was after Judge
Dredd? I want to say, Judge Dredd was like 93?
I feel like that was the period when all those action guys were starting to...
The action genre was falling out of the wayside as the CGI spectacle era was taking over.
Well, and also the ones that were coming out, as far as the action stuff, was worse.
The 80s...
The Arnold movies were starting to suck.
Yeah.
The Stallone movies started to suck. So it's not even just that, like, the CG spectacle stuff was taking over, it's that the action movies that
were being made
just weren't any good.
Nope.
starting to doubt in my ability to do this.
This should be like the climax of the game. And this is like halfway through. I can't imagine how much harder it gets after this. I miss triangles. Can we go back to triangles? Triangles didn't hunt my ass down. Oh my god!
Fucking boom.
Wow.
Fucking boom.
And then you just died immediately.
Oh, well, I'm done now. I just wanted to get through that one level. Like, I can do this.
Good job. All right.
I'm going to call that a small redemption to me.
Sure.
Whew, that was hard, though.
Yeah.
That was difficult.
Yeah, those balls hard.
Okay, well, let's see if we have any new subscribers. We do. We have Midnight of the Century.
Let's see if I can read this.
Rich is now 2 inches away from the monitor.
This text is like the smallest letters I've ever seen.
Can't
Regimon Ringek.
NSFW Wookie.
NSFW Wookie?
Well, I get it. Not safe for Wookie. That's what it means. I get it.
El Runko!
Mall Ratkle.
Fatty Moose Slime! Fatty Muslim? Fatty
Muslin.
Fatty Muslin?
Maybe.
Whatever your fucking name is! Thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it.
Oh, according to Alejandro, by the way, speedrunners can beat the entire game in less than 13 minutes.
Oh, my God.
I don't think we came close to that. Also,
No, we did not come close to that. You've been playing for 6 hours.
Thank you, by the way, Alejandro, for coming and chatting with people in the chat.
I'm sorry for doubting you. It just we had another dev in here for a game we were streaming earlier, and it seemed weird that would happen twice. So
also thank you to Ice Lizard Games for coming out and chatting with the chat during Mute Crimson Plus. We really appreciate all you guys coming out for all the game nonsense that happens. Also, this. Do you guys hear this?
It's probably really annoying.
Do you guys hear that?